Hello, watch enthusiasts. This is OJ Watley coming to you in real time, direct from What You Want HQ in Hollywood, Florida. If you like our Time Talk videos, please make sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel, What You Want Inc. Additionally, make sure to check out our website, www.whatyouwant.com, to see this watch, as well as our entire inventory of pre-owned luxury watches, categorized by brand and by price point. Also, make sure to check back often as we do update our website with new watches, new arrivals, and sneak peeks on a daily and very frequently hourly basis. So today I'm here to talk to you about a very cool Panerai watch, and a Panerai watch that you really don't see very frequently. This is the Panerai PAM 326. This is the Daylight Chronograph, the Luminor Daylight Chronograph, 44mm, PAM 326, and this particular specimen is an L series. You know, what I like most about this watch is that it features a very cool blue dial, and it's a blue dial in a titanium case, which is a rare combination in the world of Panerai, especially in 44mm. In fact, the last 44mm titanium watch that Panerai made with a blue dial, if memory serves me correctly, is the PAM 93, the titanium power reserve with the blue dial. And I would say that this watch is cut sort of from the same cloth. So this watch features a 44mm brushed titanium case, and then of course there's this awesome, almost metallic blue dial with these very crisp, green, luminous, that's a super luminova, luminous material hour markers, and of course there's an Arabic number for the 12. There is a very squarely placed date indication between the 4 and 5 o'clock hour marker. And what I like about this dial is it's that gorgeous blue. It doesn't have contrasting chronograph subdials. The whole dial is blue. It's not too cluttered. There are minute markers around the edge of the dial that are in a very light luminous green, whereas the 5 minute markers are accented by a very small Arabic number for the minute markers, but that each 5 minute marker is a little bolder, a little more easier to read. This watch definitely glows like a flashlight at night. And you know, what's interesting about this watch is it features the Valjoux 7750 movement, which, you know, as most people are familiar with, Panerai is really phasing out of these off-the-shelf sort of generic movements, if you will, in favor of their own in-house movements. So this was the last daylight chronograph, sort of in lockstep with the PAM 356, to be released with the Valjoux 7750 movement. That characteristic movement, of course, has the date indication, and you've got that recessed date adjustment pusher right there on the side of the case at 10 o'clock. That is traditionally how you tell, how you identify the movement as being a Valjoux movement, 7750 base caliber. And like I said, it is reminiscent of all of the daylight chronographs that feature the same movement. What I like about this watch is this has a different style pusher system than the traditional Luminor daylights. Instead of having the integrated sort of rectangular shaped pushers that are sort of built into the case and sort of protrude down almost into the crown protector, these have plunger style pushers. And they're just bars. They're titanium bars. They're much easier to access, much easier to activate, and they have a very nice crisp rebound to them. And I'm definitely in favor of these chronograph pushers over the integrated rectangular pushers, which sometimes kind of had a tendency to get jammed or had a tendency to become difficult to access when you really wanted to start, stop, or reset the chronograph. This watch, of course, has the solid case back because it's that Valjoux movement. There was no reason they wanted to showcase an off-the-shelf movement. So it's got the solid titanium case. And this particular specimen, as I mentioned, is an L series. To my knowledge, this watch was only made for the L and the M series. Those are the only two series that we've ever owned, is the L and the M series in the PAM 326. The L series, according to this watch, was made in only 500 pieces, which is a good indication that Panerai is phasing out of this movement, producing less and less pieces each year. You know, prior to this release, the daylight chronographs were usually released in an edition of around 1,500 pieces, sometimes even 2,500 pieces. But you can tell they're getting away from these movements by the fact that they only made 500 pieces for the L series, and I believe 500 for the M series, if I'm not mistaken. This watch has a gorgeous midnight blue alligator strap, to match that blue, almost metallic dial. You know, it could be mistaken for black in the dark or at night, but it, make no mistake, it's definitely a midnight blue, navy blue alligator strap. Very rich, nice big scales, and in my opinion, just a beautiful strap to complement this dial. You know, I also love to see this dial complemented with that sort of tobacco brown or antique brown alligator strap. I think that's a beautiful contrasting combination that gives a lot of depth and contrast to the dial versus the alligator strap. Something I also like about this watch, like I said, those blue dial watches in the Panerai lineup are really few and far between. Originally, they're reserved for the Regatta Special Editions. Then they were released with the Firenze Boutique Special Editions, and this is one of the last remaining, you know, all blue dials that wasn't a special edition. As much as it was only made for two production years, it is a regular edition piece, albeit a limited edition at only 500 pieces for the L series. This watch is complemented with the original titanium folding deployment buckle. Again, in the PAM 356, what we saw was Panerai getting away from the deployment buckles and going to the tang buckles with a leather strap. This one has the alligator strap with the folding titanium deployment buckle. Again, kind of showing that it's more of a contemporary watch rather than the 356, which with the dirty brown luminous accents on the dial, they sort of started to give it a more traditional or sort of vintage look. And thus it was complemented with a tang buckle rather than the folding deployment buckle. Of course, this watch comes with the original black rubber sports strap with the Officine and the Panerai on each side. And something else that I really like about this watch, as an L series, this watch has the new quick change strap changing system. So you are able to swap out the straps without needing a screwdriver. Rather, you use the included two-piece stylus, or you can really just use a toothpick. But by depressing on either of these pushers here on the bottoms of the lugs, it releases the lug screw and allows you to change out the straps without needing a screwdriver, at least that you're not gonna muck up the sides of the case with a screwdriver or an errant screwdriver, you know, strap change with the screwdriver slipping out of the slots. Although you will need a screwdriver to swap out the folding deployment buckle. So there you have it. This is the PAM 326, a rare bird with the blue dial, a discontinued watch now, and a watch that really wasn't made in a lot of high volume. In fact, this piece was only made in 500 pieces. I hope you enjoyed this Time Talks video as much as I've enjoyed making it. Of course, we'd love to hear your feedback. If there's anything you'd like to know more about or any way that we can improve your viewing experience, we'd love to get your comments and suggestions. As always, wear your watches in the very best of health, and thank you so much for your time today. Have a great day. This is OJ Whatley, signing off.